Today we're beginning a new series. This series will cover 10 sessions. They're only short sessions, but this is a very important subject. It's to do with Israel's prophetic journey. And in the first book of Corinthians, chapter 10 and verse 11, the Apostle Paul tells us about Israel being an example for us as we walk in this world. He said, now all these things happened to Israel as examples, and they are written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world have come. So in this first session, we're looking at a number of different things, going right back to the beginning of God's call. A man, Abraham, an everlasting covenant, a priest, Melchizedek, a family, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, a nation, Israel, 12 tribes, and a special prophecy through Joseph. Now in Genesis chapter 12 and verse 1 to 3, we see in this call to Abraham, he was in a foreign land. He was in Ur of the Chaldees. He was amongst idol worshippers, but God called him out on a special mission, a special purpose, which was going to give birth to a new nation called Israel. The Lord said, get out of your country, from your family and from your father's house, to a land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. And I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curses you. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. To Abraham was given an everlasting covenant. Genesis 17 and verse 7 says, I will establish my covenant as an everlasting covenant. This was not something temporary, it was eternal. And with this everlasting covenant came an everlasting priest. An everlasting priest for an everlasting covenant. Genesis 14, 18 to 19, we see Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought out bread and wine, prophetic of the body and blood of Christ that was going to bring about the fulfillment of this everlasting covenant. And he was the priest of God Most High. And he blessed him and said, blessed be Abram of God Most High, possessor of heaven and earth. And we see in the book of Hebrews the confirmations of this amazing priest, Melchizedek. Hebrews 7, verse 7, without doubt the lesser is blessed of the greater. You see, Melchizedek had blessed Abraham. Hebrews 7, verse 12, when the priesthood is changed, the law must be changed also. You see, the Melchizedek priesthood is a royal priesthood, a kingdom of priests. The law, under the time of Moses, was limited to one tribe. Hebrews 7:17 says, it is declared, now this is referring to Christ, you are a priest forever in the order of Melchizedek. It's a family and a nation. Genesis 12 verse 2, we see that I will make you into a great nation and I will bless you. All the families of the earth shall be blessed. Genesis 46 verse 3, he says, don't be afraid to go to Egypt. I'm going to make you a great nation. Exodus 19 and verse 6, you will be for me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. And the prophecy to Joseph, Genesis 37, 9. Listen, he said, I had another dream. And this time, the sun, the moon, and the 11 stars were bowing down to me. And they were offended by this. But this was a prophecy of the birth of the nation of Israel. And eventually Joseph said to them in Genesis 50 and verse 20, as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good in order to bring about, as it is this day, to save a nation, many people, the birth of the nation of Israel.